Fuck, let's get some tunes going in this motherfucker.
Shut up, tunes, man. Yeah.
Fuck yeah. See what we got here.
Actually,
got some killer shit.
Shark Tank. My nigga, what the fuck is this?
What the fuck is this?
Oh, shit, niggas. This my shit right here.
What's your shit? This shit sound kind of white.
White? White?
Yeah.
Niggas, this is George Michael right here, right? This one of the greatest recorder artists of all time, man. This the real OG up in here.
So, he blacked it.
You know, he light-skinned it. And then, you know, he used to roll with this nigga Ridgely.
Yeah.
And then George Michael's trying to do that solo thing, right? And then wham! Then nobody never see Ridgely ever again.
He killed the motherfucker?
Nobody ever seen him again.
Shit, I fuck with that nigga.
Yeah.
I fuck with him.
He started that shit.
Yeah, that's some
wait
real
till y'all
shit.
Hear this next track though, Dirk.
I will be your father figure. Put your tiny hands in mine.
Yo, that chorus do kick in nice though.
It does, don't it?
Yeah,
yeah. I mean, y'all hear the father figure part, right? Because my man right here, he didn't have his own positive male role model in his life.
Damn.
Yo, I never knew my daddy.
Really?
No. I will be your daddy. I will be the one who loves you till the end of time.
Man, George Michael the shit, right, man.
Right, right, dog.
Oh,
yeah,
let him,
dog,
man.
Right, man.
Yeah,
right,
love
right,
that, man.
Right.
So, Alan said,
oh, shit. What? Nigga, fuck what? Nigga.
Tell me about it, man. Was it crazy? I'm sure it should have been.
Was shit, hell's tails. Hold on to your tails, nigga. Shit was crazy. We was just dodging bullets on an everyday basis, you know, just for survival. But you know, the thing about me and Tectonic, is this our communication skills. That's the backbone of our teamwork. You feel me?
Get that.
All right.
Yeah. You know what?
Hmm.
I never told y'all niggas how I got this. Yeah. Kid stabbed me because I stole his ring pop.
That's awful, man. Yeah. Well, how old were you?
23.
Oh! Okay. Well, yeah, thanks. Thank you for sharing that.
That's
yeah.
All good.
I got one too. Check it out.
Okay, yeah, let's see that.
Mm-hmm. Buckshot. Yeah. Holding the liquor store.
Oh, man. And then he shot you, man. That's crazy.
Well, nah, actually, it made the news. And when I got back to my grandma's house, she shot me.
Okay, you know, you need to spend a little less time with your family. I'm going to advise that.
Yeah, yeah. So what you got?
Me?
Come on, man. You got a bunch of shit.
Here it is.
You gotta be modest.
Right there, man. Street fight. Appendix. Blam.
Appendix?
They took it out of my body.
What?
Mm-hmm. Y'all don't even want to hear about what went down with my wisdom teeth. Shit.
That look in your eyes.
Move! Give it back!
That I don't want to hurt.
Hey, what's up, everybody? This is a shout out to the late and great George Michael. I think he really meant a lot to, I think, the whole world, really. He was so influential in the 80s, late 80s, early 90s when he came out. My first experience with George Michael when I was a young boy, I think 7, 8, 9, 10, and my mom had got the Faith album on vinyl, and I was listening to the album, and we would listen to the album all the time. But on the vinyl version, you had all these extra photos and, you know, pictures with his shirt off, and like I just remember, oh, damn, I got something on my teeth. You know, and I'm looking at all these pictures of him with his shirt off and everything, and I'm just thinking, man, this guy seems kind of gay. What do you think? And she was like, Chad, that is not gay. That is sexy. And I'm just like, okay, well, I'm a little boy, Mom. I don't really know what sexy means, you know? I don't know anything about that, you know? And here I am, you know, in my hormonal state, you know, trying to learn all about sexuality now, all of a sudden, and I have no idea what's going on. Well, I guess. The funniest thing, so I guess the point is, I kind of knew, like, way back in the day, looking at these super gay pictures of the guy, like, okay, wow, you know, is what it is. Because I love the guy's music, so I couldn't hate the guy at all. Couldn't do it. Anyways, one of the funniest things, though, that I remember is, at the time, my mom had this boyfriend with a video camera, and they just thought it would be so funny if I would karaoke the whole album. So they got this tape of me as this 8-year-old boy, and I was singing the whole album of Faith, and then I sang, I think, track 4, I Want Your Sex, and I was like 8, and they just thought it was the funniest thing because I was saying, I want your sex, and I'm like 7, 8 years old or whatever. And yeah, that's my story, and I'll never forget that, because well, some things are just immemorable, you know, no matter what they, you know, mean, or I don't know what it means, but it was someone I'll never forget, and a great guy, and someone who put out amazing music, and who was one of the best singers, to be honest, pretty much ever, in my opinion. All right, guys, thanks.
Ha-ha! This is Doc, the new captain of the Brofist Army. Ha-ha-ha! Just try to stump me. Ha-ha-ha!
Yeah, so that's my video, guys. If you guys, if you like to, please rate, comment, and subscribe. And, yo, Poots, you can't stop me. I'm the new greatest. I'm the new greatest. But hey, if you guys want to check out some more videos, yo, check them out here and over here, and yeah.